Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I'm glad you could join me today. We're going to show you how to build this stove simply and inexpensively. Stay tuned.
Okay, what we have here is a piece of galvanized ductwork. It had been 5 feet long. I cut off one piece already. I will show how to cut this piece. This is seven inch round duct. In other words, if it was put together, it'd be approximately 7 inches round. All right. Now it's 22 inches long from this edge around to this edge. If it was laying flat, it'd be 22 inches. Alright, here's the other piece. It's already cut out and folded where the folds need to be. Okay, since this is 22 inches, I cut this piece off, which was 22 inches. This piece is 22 inches. I'm going to put the same folds in this piece. I'm going to reverse this, and I'm going to put them together, okay, just as if we're going to put together one piece. So 22 inches by 22 inches makes 44 inches, okay? Cut that in fourths. That is 11 inches. So that means this stove will be 11 inches across, 11 inches high, 11 inches across, 11 inches down the other side. All right, now let me show you how I measured it out. And we'll go ahead and cut it with tin snips. Okay, we've marked this 24 inches long. That's how long our stove is going to be. Now let's cut it. Okay, we've got this cut off at 24 inches. Now let's kind of semi-flatten it out and measure it for the folds. This is how I flatten it out, semi-flatten it out. Okay, now that we've got this flattened out pretty good, I'm going to measure from the male end. This is the female end. Hopefully you can see that okay. I am going to measure from the male end 11 inches and make a mark. Make a mark at 5.5, and let's see, 11 plus 5.5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is 16.5. Okay, that should be 11 inches in between, and it is. Okay, this right here in the middle is going to be the top of the stove. All right, we're going to do the same on the other end down here, and then we'll mark the bend lines. I've marked the fold lines here 11 inches apart. Now let me show you my folding jig. Okay, we are going to put this fold line right on the edge of the workbench right here. We're going to place this straight edge 2x4. Well, it was a 2x4. It's now approximately a 2x2. We're going to put that right over the, right at the fold line. And then we're going to clamp it down.
just like this. Okay, we've got the clamps clamped down, and you need to clamp these firmly because once the bending process starts, you don't want this board or your project to scoot. So clamp these down tight. Be sure and clamp them beyond the edge of here so it won't interfere with the bending. Okay, let's go ahead and start bending. Okay, we've got the primary bend in, but if you could see up close, you would see there's a bit of a radius here. It's not a sharp 90, so we're going to take care of that now. We're just going to take a small board and a hammer, and we're going to work along this whole thing, turning this wider radius into a sharp 90 degree corner. And this is why you need these clamps clamped down tight. All right, that is pretty good, just like that. Now I think I'm going to go through and just go ahead and tap this with the hammer all the way through. Okay, that looks great. Now, a tip. As you're doing this, you want to check and make sure, occasionally, periodically check your board, your straight edge that you've got clamped down, to make sure that it hasn't shifted inward. You want to keep it out on the edge so that you can work this edge. Now, let's take it out, take a look at it. Okay, there's the edge. Hopefully you can see that, see how it turned out. All right, we've got both sides bent now. Before we go on, there's something I forgot to mention. Okay, I did say that this was a 2x4 originally. Okay, this is a 2x4 that's been cut off, so it has a nice 90 degree edge right here. Okay, the original edge of the 2x4 can have a bit of a radius on it, and I don't want that. I want a nice 90 degree edge. I have chosen to use 4-inch galvanized ductwork as my stovepipe. So I need to mark out the top here with a 4-inch hole. So I found this partially used roll of tape that has a 4-inch diameter. What I did was I marked this out and cut it out at the 4-inch dimensions. Okay, I am going to put this right to the end here, flush with the end, and I'm going to put it right to this side. The reason why is because I want my stovepipe to be slightly off-center. I don't want it to be in the middle. The reason for that is this will give me a little bit of room over here to, like, place a coffee pot or whatever still give me a little bit of room. So let's go ahead and mark this out. There we go. You probably can't see that, but just know that it's there. Now, I am going to get a different pen for right now. That one was kind of weak. All right, now I am going to mark the inside of this for a smaller diameter hole. This is the hole I'm going to cut out, and you'll see why in a little bit. I'm going to cut out this smaller diameter hole. Okay, you probably are wondering, what is the dimensions of this smaller hole? Okay, looks like it's about 2 7/8. That's not really critical. Perhaps a little bit wider hole might be better. Because we've got a full about half inch in between these two. You'll see how this all fits together later. Okay, right now I am going to drill a hole through here and then start cutting it out. Drill a hole through here so that I can get the point of my tent snips in here. Okay, now speaking of tin snips, this is a left-hand turn, a left-turn tin snips. They are, many metal snips are made to cut left or to cut right. This one is made to cut a left-hand circle. Keep that in mind when you start to cut out your circle. Okay, we've got our circle cut out. Now we go to the next step. All right, we've got our hole cut out. We've got this form clamped on here. Now, what we're going to do, as you can see, I've clamped a 2x4 onto here. I'm going to go ahead and clamp this down here. All right, now, what we're going to do is we're going to proceed to bend this peen, this lip over. And the reason for that is if we just had a raw edge here to stick the pipe in, this wouldn't be very durable. So I'm going to peen over this edge, make it a more durable opening. So you just got to work your way around and around and around and around and around this circle, just working a little bit, bending it down. Round. Okay, now as you bend this, you need to make sure that you bend this all the way back to the original circle, and don't just bend down the outer edge. It's important not to try to force this down, but just gently work it around and around and around. Okay, here is the whole stovepipe hole, looking at it from the inside. Okay, let's see how the stovepipe fits. Let's go ahead and give it a try. looks like that'll work just great. Okay, let's go on to the next step. Okay, now, this female end, if you will, tends to get smashed during cutting, trimming, whatnot. So we need to go through and make sure that it is, it will accept the other half. Hopefully you can see how this one is smashed in on the end right here. Okay, we are gonna widen that back out again. Okay, we'll do that on both sides, and then it's time to assemble the halves. Okay, that went together real easy. Now, let's do the other side. Okay, the previous side popped apart. All right, we have a flat sheet of the galvanized metal that it's ductwork. Came in the, I found it in the ductwork section of Lowe's Hardware. All right, it is 16 inches by 34 and a half about. Okay, so I've marked it out in 15 inch square here. Okay, and then I'm going to cut out 2-inch square in each corner of these two 15-inch squares. All right, we've got the larger sheet cut out. It is 15 by 15 inches. Okay, these lines are 2 inches deep. Now what we gotta do is we gotta line this up with the edge of the workbench and bend it just like we did the round ductwork, the stove body. Okay, this inner square is 11 inches by 11 inches. So I think you can kind of see what we're gonna try to achieve here. All right, right here I'm making a baffle for inside the stove, and I clamp this down just like I did the stove body, bent this up. Okay, this is a baffle, but it's the same way I made the ends to the stove body. Okay, when I've showed how you can clamp both ends here to fold up a side, but what happens when you get to where you can't run the board all the way through, then what do? You do this. You clamp it down just like we've always been doing, but on this side you need to extend the, let me loosen this up so you can see what I did. You turn the clamp over and run this down enough that this arm will clear the sidewall here. Okay, once I get all three sides done here, you do the third side the same way, but what do you do when you get to the fourth side? Well, I'll show you that. All right, here we are with the front. The front and the rear, they're both identical. This just happens to be the front. And this is how we bend up this last edge. You have to have a board that fits in between the sides. And then you have to reach down in like that on both sides. That way you're not going to crush these edges right here. Crank this down a little bit tighter so it won't scoot around on us, and tighten up that edge. There's the front. Now, what we need to do is we need to go around, we need to mark the 1 inch from here up, 1 inch mark all the way around. All right, this is how, this is what we got to do next. I have got this right, the 1 inch line right on the edge of the workbench, and I'm gonna peen that over with the hammer. All right, that's what it looks like. That's what we're trying to achieve. And I'll go ahead and do that on all four sides here. All right, this was a kind of a tight fit, but I've now got this, I got the 90s bent on here, and I've got it slipped into the end of the stove body. Now what we gotta do is fold these over. There we go. Now, if you haven't already figured it out, this provides quite an effective seal from the end onto the body. Very little air leaks. Let me give you a close-up of a corner here so you can see what we're talking about. Okay, there's a close-up of a corner. It is sealed quite well. All right. Now, I put bolts on here from the inside and put nuts on. So this would be for the legs. All right, before we go on, let me show you how I tighten this up. I've got a board here, and I put this behind it, the sledgehammer. Okay, that tightens up the edge real good. As you can see, that makes a really nice seal. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do that on all four. And then what I'm going to do is drill through here, here, and here, and put in rivets. And I am using steel rivets. Here, let me show you. These are the rivets I'm using. They are 1/8 inch body, 1/8 inch grip. There it is with the rivets all in place. Three on each side. Now I'm only putting three on each side for now. I want to, I only have 50 pop rivets. So I want to finish getting everything put together. And then if I have any pop rivets left over, I'll go back in and I'll fill in here with as many pop rivets as I have left.
Okay, here's the stove marked out for the door. Here is the bottom. You can see the leg bolt. This is the bottom. I did it 2 inches up to the bottom of the door, 2 inches down, and an inch and a half in from the sides. Now, as you can see, I've got an inner square marked out here. And what that's for is I'm going to cut this inner square and then cut each of these points and fold it under. The reason for that is to make the edge here so that it's not a raw edge. It'll be more user friendly. Plus it'll help to give the stove structural integrity, help keep the stove firmer, help keep this door area firmer so it doesn't warp as easily.
The hinges here, and I installed this type of latch on the door. I wanted a latch at the bottom and the top so that as the stove door warps, it'll be held in at the top and the bottom. I also put them in upside down on purpose. This is the bottom. This is the top of the stove. I wanted these pins to be out to where they're sticking out from the stove. If I put them in the way they were supposed to be, then they would be down and they'd be hard to operate. Okay, I may find that I might have to put a little detent or whatever the word is here to keep them from sliding out, but I don't think so. So there's the door, and inside you can see a baffle that I put in as well. Notice that it slants down towards the back. You can see the stove pipe opening. Okay, the reason why it slopes down is because the bottom of the pipe is going to stick, you know, quite a bit even below there. So it needs room for the gases to flow up and flow down and up the pipe then. The reason why I'm using a baffle is because I've never used one before, but they are rumored to be excellent at helping to prevent sparks from going up the chimney. So I want that with my nylon hot tent. All right, I've got the air intake finished. Works like that. I've got a small tiny spring underneath of this bolt, and it's double nutted on the inside. So it works like that. If the spring ever gives out, then this will just fall down and it'll close off the air intake. So, okay, got that done. Now, here's the legs. I made the legs out of copper pipe because that's what I had available. I would have rather have used aluminum angle aluminum, but this is what I had. So I made it work. Okay, I run a couple of bolts. I run a bolt through the side of the stove here, and I hammered this copper, 3/4 inch copper pipe. I hammered it flat. I did the same here, bent it over, put a rivet through, and that prevents it from opening up too far. I made one leg a little bit wider than the other leg. And that's so that they will lay flat like that. Also, when I'm transporting it, I can carry it as a handle. All right, let's go set it up outside and see how it works. Now, in this stove, there are about 52 rivets as it stands right now, the way it's put together right now. And be sure and use steel rivets. Okay, now this is galvanized metal, and you don't want to light this off for the first time in an enclosed area. Be sure and light it up outside, burn it off real good, because galvanized metal is toxic as it burns off. Once it burns off, then it's safe. So be sure and burn it off outside real good. Okay, you can see it's burning there pretty good. And it's in the process of burning off the galvanizing. Okay, this is burnt off, it's safe. This here is still being burnt off. Same with the pipe here. You can see at the point where the pipe is burnt off. I don't know if you can see it or not. But you can, right here, it's very shiny, right at the transition. That's where stuff is kind of melted. And, that's the result of after it's burnt off. The stove seems to burn very well. And I'm surprised that it drafts quite well as well. Very little smoke comes out of the door after. Initially you open up the door, something's going to come out if you open it up fast like I just did. But it seems to draft real well. All in all, it's a great success. The galvanizing is just about all burn off. So I'll continue to burn it and get that galvanizing all off before I put it in a tent. Well, I hope you enjoyed this, and I thank you for joining me. And we'll see you guys on the next video. You take care.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.